Hello guys, welcome to this podcast Everyday Talkies, which ironically does not come out daily. I am Anshul and I talk about random things to random people, majorly about life, perspectives and thinking process. It's like an interview or let's say more of a conversation with one or two guests about random topics that interest us. To be really honest, it's just a way to reduce my inhibitions in talking to people. So come join me and enjoy. Hello guys, welcome to the new episode of Everyday Talkies. So we're planning to start a mini series called The Book Corner, where me and Pushkar, or majorly Pushkar, discusses his interests towards his favorite authors, books, and gives his views on all of that. So it might be a way where you can learn about the different literary figures or different authors or different books that you might want to read in future. So I won't blabber too much and give this platform over to Pushkar, who will start off this series. So Pushkar, over to you. And whom are we learning about today?
Okay, hello everyone. So when Anshul came to me with this idea of starting like a mini series with 10-15 minute episodes about something I was passionate about, I thought the first thing I thought of was Star Trek, obviously. But then I thought it would be better for me to talk about something that I don't really get to talk about with anyone, which is authors, you know. Generally, I think these days what mostly people like to talk about is books, you know. You have this one really good book and we love to discuss books and stories and this and that. Very rarely do we discuss authors. So I thought, you know, this would be like a good platform for me to talk about authors, because I think of myself as one at least. I mean, I don't know if I am one, but let's see. So I thought, why not talk about the people who are behind these stories? And for the first episode, I thought the best way to start it would be to find an author that I really feel close to, and not in a way like I really like, I think he's the greatest author ever, but someone who is very close to my literary experience. So today we'll be talking about Satyajit Ray. I'm sure when you hear the word Satyajit Ray, what obviously comes to mind are his movies, which are obviously, you know, award-winning artful cinema, which is about poor people and conflicted women. And you have these old people who are, it's tradition versus modernity and all these heavy subjects, and his movies are generally very sad and, you know, slow and dreary. And when you tend to think of Satyajit Ray, you think of this really serious filmmaker. But you guys, Satyajit Ray was a nerd. If you look at his literary work, if you look at it, is obvious that he was a big science fiction fan. He was a nerd, you know. And the great thing about Satyajit Ray's writing is that he was, I think, one of the first Indian sci-fi authors. I mean, obviously you had authors like Jules Verne, who was obviously interested in telling a lot of stories that were based in India. He wrote 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea and The Mysterious Island, which were both about Captain Nemo. And he also wrote The Steam House, which is a sci-fi story about Nana Sahib. But Satyajit Ray's science fiction was very different. I think what I relate to most about his work is that his stories were about real people living in real places. It was about office clerks and teachers who were living in small towns, or like in you know, the city of Kolkata, and they used to visit real places like Curzon Park, and you know, they were like us. They were normal people, real people, who then had experiences who were larger than life, that were, you know, extraterrestrial, that were phantasmagorical experiences. The most famous of Satyajit Ray's stories probably is Bonku Babu's Friend, which is about a man living in a village who goes into the woods and one night comes across a 4-foot alien who becomes his friend. And if that sounds familiar, it's because that story had a huge influence on what became Steven Spielberg's E.T. And which is funny, because then E.T. was remade as Koi Mil Gaya in India. So it kind of came full circle, but in a really shitty way. But yeah, that's what Ray was.
So first of all, tell us about why was he so famous? Like, what are the things that inspired people at that time when he was present, and what influenced people that he became this literary giant that we all know?
Satyajit Ray, as a literary icon, became famous because of a lot of his serialized work. He had recurring characters like Feluda and Professor Shonku, who were all, I mean, you can see that they were all derivations of other sci-fi works. Like he derived a lot from, you know, H.G. Wells and Arthur Conan Doyle. But I think what resonates with me the most, what I think is remarkable, is that even if that stuff was derivative, he took those characters and he thought about them very seriously. He treated them as real. And in his stories, he put them in stories where they interacted with a world that was not, you know, it wasn't a larger than life, you know, fantastical world. It was our world. It was real. It was the real world. And today you can see these things in stories like Arrival or, you know, The Martian, these big budget Hollywood movies. But Satyajit Ray was writing about these things way back in the 1950s. And I think it's really sad that that did not, you know, become mainstream. It did not flourish, at least in the Indian literary or film scene, you know, because it's so wonderful for me to think about a person who writing stories about people that I may know, you know, or writing stories about me, someone who would maybe just like go into the forest on a trek one day and find an egg of a monster that will grow up to, you know, destroy the world. It's amazing to think that he thought of these stories so seriously, and he made such amazing tales that would really capture the imagination of someone who's not only young, but someone who is passionate about stories, about science fiction, about testing the limits of humanity, you know.
Apart from the sci-fi stuff, like, what other works do you think, like, influenced you personally? He was a writer as well as a filmmaker, so what are the other works that influenced you?
Talk about him as a filmmaker, obviously you have to... one thing I realized was, of all the films that I've seen of his, like, I wouldn't say I've seen all of them, but of the major ones, the ones that are the most famous, none of them are films that he wrote. He usually adapted his films from, you know, novels written by other people. So I think it's interesting to see that there is such a contrast between what his movies were about and what his stories were about. And I think it's fair to say that there was a reason that he could not maybe make the films that maybe he wanted to make, because usually he would work on like very tiny budgets and making stories about pterodactyls and, you know, ancient monsters and aliens. Would I don't think he would have the budget for it, so he was like in a corner when it came to, you know, making the these stories. So I think that's why he went in a literary route, because if you look at his writing, it's not romanticized writing, it's not very worldly writing, it's very clean, simple, clear prose, which is more about communicating what his thoughts are rather than, you know, writing poetry. So I think that is also something that influenced me when I finally decided to write my novel, is that Satyajit Ray wrote in a way that was simple, but it was honest, it was sincere, and it was serious in a way that did not make fun of the fact that these were stories about robots and artificial intelligence and aliens and monsters. He took those things very seriously. He thought about them with consideration. He thought about them with love and humanity. And, you know, he really did a lot of work to further, I think, the science fiction genre that he wrote about. And even his other stuff, like, you know, Feluda, which were detective stories, and his crime thrillers, all of these were also treated not as, you know, pulpy, cheap stuff. It was treated as something that was truly fascinating, something that you would want to live. He created a world that you would want to live in, and more often than not, it was a world you could live in. Like, you read a Feluda story that takes place in Darjeeling, and you are so engrossed in that world that when you go to Darjeeling, you can be like, oh, this is like this world I have read about. This, it's such an interesting world. It gives you such joy. So I think a lot of that has influenced me as a writer when writing science fiction or just anything, that whatever you write about, no matter how stupid it may seem, like if you're writing about Godzilla, if you're writing about giant robots fighting each other, if you're writing about, say, swamp monsters or bugs or whatever, if you're writing about space whales, you have to do it in a way that does not make fun of the fact, does not belittle that, it does not make you feel embarrassed that you're writing about these things. It, you know, it makes you feel powerful. It makes you feel a lot of awe and wonder thinking about this stuff, you know, imagining these things, which I think it's amazing. And I cannot, you know, thank Satyajit Ray enough for, you know, being there, that I can, you know, stand on the shoulders of this man and, you know, dream of writing something better.
Personally, if you would have to say, what is your favorite literature work of Satyajit Ray and a movie made by Satyajit Ray?
My personal favorites, I would. It's so hard to choose. Well, his films, obviously, I think Jalsaghar is my favorite. It's also called The Music Room in English. I think everybody should watch that movie. It's a very low budget, low stakes movie, but it's almost Shakespearean in its storytelling, and it really shows how much Satyajit Ray was a symbolic and a humanistic filmmaker. And also, when it comes to his stories, I think I cannot do better than Bonku Babu's Friend, because it's such a novel idea that it's hard to think that nobody thought about it in such a way. Like, before Bonku Babu's Friend, if you looked at stories about aliens, if you looked at, you know, H.G. Wells' War of the Worlds, if you looked at other, you know, The Tempest, which has the first alienistic monsters, if you think of all these stories, aliens were looked at as, you know, this kind of foreign entity that was, you know, out to destroy us, that was this, you know, monstrous evil kind of thing, race that would, you know, come and destroy us. So Bonku Babu's Friend is really the first story where it kind of takes the alien and shrinks it down to a human level. It creates a very loving environment where a person meets an alien, befriends him, and you know, they exchange information, and it's treated in a very casual way. It's not like, you know, the alien comes and the person is afraid of him, or like he screams and runs away like a, you know, 1950s heroine. It's done so considerately, it's done so thoughtfully, and it's done with such delicacy that I wish more people would read it. I wish more people think about writing characters, think about writing stories in the way that he wrote, which was a very, I keep using the word sincere, but that is what it is. Like, it's very sincere, it's very heartfelt, it's very real. And when you read those stories, you feel like you live in a world that is a bit more magical than, you know, a bit more magical, a bit more kinder, a bit more nicer than, you know, maybe the world that we live in right now.
Nicely said. Okay, so just to come to this episode and to bring everything to a close, if you had to rant to all the people on why they should follow Satyajit Ray and read his works or follow his movies, you know, how would you do that?
Everything I've said is just like a big, you know, big loud cry that basically is saying, like, go read his work, you know, go read Satyajit Ray, because he wrote with such diversity, he wrote so many different kinds of stories that it will, I promise you, if you read his work, it will expand your horizons beyond just what we think of, you know, Indian films or Indian stories as story. It will blow open these doors that will let you explore the limits of humanity, the limits of the universe with his stories. It will expand your imagination beyond what you might think Indian stories are capable of.
Nice. And do you remember any scene or, let's say, a paragraph or something which really touched you, and then we'll close it off, we won't prolong it long?
Okay, if I had to pick a quote, I think it would obviously be from Bonku Babu's Friend. And it would be, it's, okay, the context is, it's the alien says this to the human that he meets about just humanity in general. He says, look, I have been watching you, and I have examined your arms and legs. You belong to a much inferior species. There is no doubt about that. However, as human beings go, you are not too bad. I mean, you are a good man, but you have a major fault. You are much too meek and mild. That is why you have made so little progress in life. You must always speak up against injustice and protest if anyone hurts or insults you without any provocation. To take it quietly is wrong, not just for man, but for any creature anywhere.
Hey, that's nice. It's actually, given the current scenario, it holds absolute truth and should be valid to a lot of people. So yeah, thank you for this amazing quote to end on. And thanks, Pushkar, for the literally the knowledge about Satyajit Ray and ranting about it for the last, I think, 10-15 minutes, because we want to keep these episodes short. We want people to capture as much knowledge as they can, know about these literary figures and follow them, and, you know, explore the world of Indian cinema or literary figures whom they don't know. Like, people usually bash upon Indian cinema, Bollywood and all of that, and given the current condition, you should at some point. But when you see the rich heritage that we come from, it is something which obviously we should follow. So thanks, Pushkar, for all of this, and we'll come back with a new episode in this series with another author or another book. Till then, thank you. Bye bye.
Bye bye. Hopefully from next time I can do it without Anshul's help.
sure.
thank you to all the listeners. I'll catch up with you again soon with someone new and lots of interesting discussions. So, bye.